Center of gravity. Now, children, what is center of gravity? We know that the gravitational force is always attractive. Gravity always attracts towards the earth. It attracts every particle towards its center, and that is called force of gravity, right? And due to the force of gravity, every particle has its weight. Now consider a particle, a body. Consider a body which is made up of large number of particles. It's made up of large number of particles of weight W1, W2, W3 and so on. As the size of the body is quite small compared to the earth, the size of the body is quite small compared to the earth, the force of gravity acting on all these particles can be regarded as parallel to each other. As the size of the body is quite small compared to the size of the earth, we can assume that all these weights are acting parallel to each other. All these parallel forces, they all act in the same direction. In which direction? It is vertically downwards towards the center of the earth. Now I can replace all these weights by a single weight W acting at a point, and that is called the center of gravity of that body. Now, if you take a moment about the center of gravity of all these forces, then these weights is acting this side, they will produce a clockwise moment about the center of gravity. W3, W1, W2, W7, they will give anti-clockwise moment. W4 is acting through the center of gravity. So W4 will not give any moment. Now if you add all the moments about the CG, it will come out to be zero. So that is what a center of gravity is, children. The weight W is considered to act at the point G, called the center of gravity, where the algebraic sum of moments due to all the weights of each particle about G is zero. About G, if you take the moments of all the particles, it will be zero. Then G is called the center of gravity. So the resultant weight acts to the center of gravity, and all the moments about the center of gravity will be zero. Now let us go to the definition of center of gravity. Center of gravity of a body is a point about which the algebraic sum of moments of weights of all the particle is zero, and the entire weight acts at that point. Now, two important points to note. Number one, the position of the center of gravity of a given mass, it depends on the shape, that is on the distribution of mass. Now, what does it mean? See, you have a body, and say the center has a greater mass. So what happens? The center of gravity will be to near the center. But if you have a body where the outside has a greater mass, more dense, then the center of gravity will shift. That means if you have a body, say, at the center it is more dense, and here the density is less, CG will be closer to the center. On the other hand, if you have a body where it has a greater mass outside and less mass inside, center of gravity will shift towards the outside. So, position of center of gravity of a given mass depends on the shape, that is on the distribution of mass on it. Now, it is not necessary that the center of gravity should lie within the material of a body. For a ring or a hollow sphere, center lies inside where there is no material. If you have a ring, the center lies here. So it does not mean that the center of gravity will always be within the material of the body. It can be outside also. Now, center of gravity for regular objects, children, this chart is very important for your exam. You have to learn. Now, for a rod, where is the center of gravity? It is at the midpoint. For a circular disc, where is the center of gravity? Geometric center. For a sphere, it is the geometric center. For a cylinder, children, then the center of gravity lies at the midpoint on the axis of the cylinder. This is the axis of the cylinder. Now, if you have a solid cone, then the center of gravity will lie h by 4 from the base on its axis. You have to learn this, children. I'll give you a video after this. Go through it. Hollow cone. If you have a hollow cone, then the center of gravity will lie h by 3 from the base on its axis. For a circular ring, where is it? At the center of the ring. Circular ring, it is at the center. For a triangular lamina, it is at the point of intersection of the medians. Look here. This is a triangular lamina. Center of gravity lies at the intersection of the medians. For a parallelogram, it is at the intersection of the diagonals. So you have to learn this chart very well. Now, for regular bodies, you can get center of gravity with this chart. But what about irregular body? I will give you a video on regular body and an irregular body. Go through it after this. Now, suppose you have an irregular lamina, children. This is an irregular lamina. Now, what you are going to do, you are going to make, say, 3 holes with pins. And from a stand, let it hang first from A. You will see, after oscillating for some time, the lamina will come to rest. Take a plumb line. I will be showing you in the video what is a plumb line. Take a plumb line and you attach the string over here. The plumb line will show like this. Now, mark this point. Then, draw a line. After this, shift the lamina and let the lamina hang from the point B. Let B come over here. Repeat the same process. Mark the point E. Join BE. Now, these two lines will intersect at a point. After that, let the lamina hang from the point C and you get the line CF. All the lines intersect at a common point, that is the center of gravity. Now, why is it so? Children, whenever a body hangs in equilibrium, the center of gravity will lie just below the point of suspension. So, center of gravity when the body is hanging from A will lie on the line AD. Now when you shift the lamina and bring B over here, then center of gravity will lie on the line BE. Again, when it is hanging from C, center of gravity will lie on the line CF. Now what is the option? If they are lying on all the three lines, then there is only one option. The center of gravity will lie at the intersection of the three lines. See here, there is an important line to follow. See, it is noticed that the lines AD, BE, CF intersect at a common point, which is called the center of gravity of the lamina. Okay.